Hello YouTube, this is Tiki Bomber here, and I am slowly catching up with all the Bearing drama about what happened with him. First and foremost, I don't really condone to doxing anybody, regardless of their viewpoints about what they would agree or disagree with you upon. Exposing personal information such as the home address, full name, work location, work phone number, home phone number, cell phone numbers, kids' schools, and so on and so forth should be illegal. But I had recently learned that having an anonymous identity on the internet is an illegal thing. But I was like, well, that's kind of weird. In my opinion, having an anonymous identity, like myself being Tiki Bomber, is actually protecting me as an individual from being doxxed, because I do have a mother who has a serious health condition, and a little brother who has a serious mental disorder, as well as a sister who has severe anxiety that I am protecting when I use my when I use my anonymous identity. And by that standard alone, I don't think it should be illegal, but according to the internet, it is in fact illegal to not use your real identity. So this had sparked the interest about doxing in my regards, if it's illegal or legal. And while I was scouring the internet for this information, I was directed to several news articles, which I will be posting in the description below for this video, about if doxing is considered legal or illegal. And it seems to be a toss-up between both sides. People do say that it's legal, which makes no sense to me, considering people use doxing as a means to get other people fired simply for disagreeing with them. But at the same time, it's classified as being illegal, which makes a lot of sense, except for in the case of police officers looking for an individual and having to use doxing as a method to find that individual, either to save them or to stop them from committing crimes, such as like gun shootings and so on. So I'm gonna ask you guys, go ahead and tell me in the comment section below of this video if you feel that doxing is either legal or illegal. And go ahead and give me your reasons why that it should be considered legal or illegal. I mean, much like trespassing is considered illegal, do you think that this is a form of trespassing, or if you think this is nothing more than just a bunch of people playing fooey at the internet and so forth? Without further ado, let me go ahead and get right on into it. Starting with the first article here. This is by patch.com. I'm a Massachusetts Malden. What is docking? Doxing? Yes, it is illegal. So first off, we start off right away with somebody who's claiming that doxing is in fact illegal. And that's perfectly acceptable. That's fine. Sit there and say that it's illegal if you want. I'm not going to accuse you of not lo about lying, but I also understand why they would say that it is illegal. It harms people. It threatens people to the point that they are stalked, to the point that they are receiving death threats, bomb threats, and threats to their family and loved ones. Have you ever seen your personal information on a public forum? Have you ever seen your personal information grayed out? If you have, know that it's not only cowardly, but also illegal. There is a name for it, doxing. According to Wikipedia, doxing, or spelling variant doxing, is an abbreviation of document tracing, the internet-based practice of researching and publishing personal identifiable information about an individual. The methods employed in pursuit of this information ranging from searching publicly available database and social media websites like Facebook to hacking and social engineering. It's closely related to cyber vigilantism, hacktivism, and cyberbullying. Also, keep this in mind, doxing violates the terms of service of most legitimate online news information opinion sites. Why doxing is always illegal? And of course, they have a link here. if you feel like you want to go ahead and look more into this, I, like I said, I will be putting the link in the description below. This ad, it just lists off some reasons why doxing is considered illegal. Now we're going to go to the next section, which actually happens to be Reddit. And there are some sites that I do not like to use. However, since the idea of doxing is like so vast on people believing that it's legal, believing that it's illegal, I'm using these other sites as a source for the actual truth about this. So the question reads, would doxing be legal if the information was obtained through legal means, such as Google and social media searching? Pretty sure it doesn't matter where, but I live in California in the United States. And there are, of course, replied with 11 comments, the first one being improperly cited. What makes you think doxing is ever illegal? It's frowned upon and published or banned by services such as Reddit, but I'm not aware of it being illegal anywhere. And then, of course, you have another response here. It says, this is an interesting question. I remember hearing a couple of cases that were successfully converted people of doxing, but they had to use a circular path to get it, i.e. they were not convicted for doxing, but for something that was illegal that they were able to relate directly to the doxing. The takeaway was there is some specific information that is protected that you cannot post. However, some you can name, for an example, is not illegal, whereas the name of address, a name and address is. Looks like doxing is in pure sense is not illegal. However, some information is restricted personal information with respect to an individual's social security number, the home address, home phone number, mobile phone number, personal email, or home fax number of and identifiable to that individual. This only applies to covered persons, which are a number of positions and persons, basically military, law enforcement, federal law enforcement, etc. So it's illegal to post specific information about people in specific positions. Also, all the threatening, intimidating laws still apply, which is how I think most people interpret doxing, which makes it dangerous even if it's not technically illegal. So right here, we see one person who actually gives off how exactly it's illegal, but at the same time, it's still not illegal. And then we have another person who has stated that doxing is in fact frowned upon and punished or bannable by website services, much like Reddit, Facebook, Tumblr, Dramatica. Encyclopedia Dramatica actually does ban people for doxing other individuals. But it's not technically illegal, or it's not technically considered a crime. So we're going to go into the next page, which happens to be Wikipedia. Again, something that I really don't like to use Wikipedia for any resourcing whatsoever, but it's going to happen. And you know what? I'll worry about that later. From Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia. We're going to look at the common techniques for this. I'm not going to go through these examples because they are listed in the website itself. So we're going to see the common techniques. Hackers, police officers, and amateur devices alike can harvest the information from the internet about individuals. There is no particular structure in place for doxing, meaning a hacker may seek out any kind of information related to the target. A basic web search can yield results. Social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, and LinkedIn offer a wealth of private information. Because many users have high levels of self-disclosure, i.e. sharing their photos, place of employment, phone numbers, emails, address, etc., but low levels of security. It is also possible to extrapolate a person's name and home address from a cell phone number, though such services such as reverse phone lookup, which, by the way, does cost money. And half the time, they don't even have the correct phone number associated to the individual. So it's like a 50-50 chance on that. Social engineering has been used to extract information from government sources or phone companies. In addition to these a hacker may use other methods to harvest information. These include information searched by domain name and location searching based on an individual's IP address. Once people have been exposed to through doxing, they may be targeted for harassment through methods such as harassment in person, fake signups for mail and pizza deliveries, or through swatting, dispatching armed police to their house through spoofed tips. And if I remember right, swatting is definitely against the law because you're involving the police enforcement to use the brutality that they have been authorized to identify and disengage into a very dangerous situation and shut down whatever it is that they're supposed to be shutting down. Which half the time, a lot of the time when people get swatted, like live streamers, they will get swatted while in a live stream by somebody because they accidentally doxed themselves or somebody went and found out their information. And it's never a good end result on what happens because they're always being accused of doing something illegal, like abusing their spouse or holding kids captive or something like that. And the police go in there expecting a fight and they are found out to not only be involved with nothing in relations of that, but it's all in a live stream, and would encourage the police to not take the serious calls more seriously, such as the people who would call in saying, hey, I'm being held captive. They're going to be second guessing at that point. You know, it's much like the false rape accusations that get all this publicity versus the real rape accusations that get no publicity. You're more likely to believe the false rape accusations, but then there's going to be a point where you hear all these false rape accusations coming out and being false rape accusations, and then when somebody with a real rape accusation comes out, you're a lot less likely to believe them than you would originally beforehand because of all the false rapes that have been thrown around. It is important to note that a hacker may obtain an individual's docs without making the information public. A hacker may harvest a victim's information in order to break into their internet accounts or to take over their social media accounts. The victim may also be shown their details as proof that they have been doxed in order to intimidate them. Doxing is therefore a standard tactic of online harassment and has been used by people associated with 4chan, the Gamergate controversy, and anti-vaccine activists. The ethics of doxing by journalists on matters that they assert are issues of public interest is an area of much controversy. Many authors have argued that doxing in journalism blurs the lines between revealing information in the public, in the interest of the public, and releasing information about an individual's private life against their wishes. So we're shown again how this is both a illegal but legal standpoint, and especially in journalism, it is a very gray area where there is controversy between it being illegal and legal based on public interests and the individual's private life against their wishes, you know. So I'm going to go into the next one, which is another Reddit page. This is a legit PSA on how to deal with e-crimes. Doxing is literally a crime, illegal. As in, if it's done, you can go to the police. You should, too. Most of these little shit slingers live in mom's basement. They're out. By the way, hackers don't live in their mama's basements. Most of the time, hackers are working on high data end projects and use hacking as a side hobby. I mean, several of them might actually work for the government and would be doxing people just because they want to make sure that the government has all the information that they need on everybody. You know, conspiracy theory thrown out there. They are out to prey on people to get the jump on them. which I might add they managed to do, but having a rant on Reddit about them harassing you, you are legitimizing what they are doing. Well fucking done. You're doing the one thing you're not supposed to be doing when dealing with online harassment. If you or your friends were doxed, advise them to contact the local authorities. Do not publicize doxing made against you or your friends. Do not address harassment directed against you or your friends. If you do, all you achieve is bring on more harassment, not less. Simply pick up the phone and dial the police. These people thrive on attention. Don't give it to them like you're doing so right now. So they've stated that it is, in fact, a crime. It is illegal. It is a form of bullying. It is a form of harassment. And in order to address doxing issues, you are to call the police immediately and let the police know. Which, you know, I actually do encourage people to do. If there is a crime being committed, instead of flipping your phone out to record the action, you should be calling the fucking cops instead. Alright, and then there is a reply. There's 17 comments on this particular page, but there is a reply saying, no, doxing is in fact legal. Doxing is mostly based on collecting information that is already available on the internet. Yes, there are some situations when your Facebook can be hacked, and your personal info that's not available for the public, retrieved and shared. This is illegal, but not always. It highly depends on the states and countries. Hacking is illegal. Harassing is illegal, not in all places. Doxing is unethical. And Strange Orange is replying as well. Totally ignoring right now the legality of doxing, I would like to make my own PSA. Be careful about the information you make public online and the connections you have between different social media services that may host information about you. That is some very positive information right here to be stating. You should always be careful about the information you make public online. It's like I said, I use anonymity for myself. And there's plenty of other people who use anonymity because they are protecting their family. Because they are protecting their jobs. You know? And purposely searching out their information to cause harm to them is in fact a form of harassment. It can be seen as stalking. But as soon as you dox their information and you make it public, then that's a whole different story. You are exposing their lives to strangers whom they have not consented to be seeing this information, and you're trying to destroy them. You are trying to purposely destroy them, and you don't care. As an individual of myself, as a human being myself, I find that to be disgusting. So, yeah. Yo Mama Beat actually says, LOL, you are so close about how law enforcement works, yet you make yourself out to be such an expert. So, contact the police online. Don't call the police because they really can't do anything. But if you contact the police online, they'll be able to do more because of the fact that it's all on the internet. It's all connected. That way, they can go into the investigations quicker and actually pull out the information. However, when there is a crime being reported and you're not online, or it's not happening on the internet itself, such as harassment or doxing or death threats, which should be reported to the authorities as well, you are to call the police. Call them. If you are assaulted, call them. It doesn't matter what other people say or think, you call the police. All right? So, let's look at the next one. Doxing grows in popularity as the legitimacy of the bullying tactic remains murky. It is a truth universally acknowledged that once something is on the internet, it's there for good. Data collecting is suddenly hitting the public's awareness, but your internet footprint is vaster than you know. And doxing is here to take advantage of that. Doxing, sometimes spelled doxing with two X's, is the act of internet researching someone and broadcasting the information that could potentially be personally identifying It is frequently a bullying tactic, one that's been used for things like Gamergate, unmasking Reddit trolls, or anonymous methods of protecting those that need it. Recently, Uber executive Emil Michael suggests the ride-sharing company hire a team of opposition researchers and journalists to collect the publicized dirt on reporters who author pieces critical of the company. In describing the tactic, which he heard describing firsthand at a private dinner with Michael BuzzFeed's Ben Smith, writes, "That team could," Michael said, "help Uber fight back against the press. They looked into your personal lives, your families, and give the media a taste of its own medicine." As could be expecting, doxing a strategy that's generally frowned upon, but when it comes to those being doxed or threatened with it, where does the law fall? Well, it's a bit unclear. And this is the first part of the whole thing, like out of probably three other reports or four other sites. 34 other sites had stated that it was illegal or that it's legal, and it's clearly unclear about if doxing is legal or not. This is the first page that we come across that's saying, well, it is unclear. You know, it's a bit unclear because we don't know if it's legal or illegal. The act of doxing itself is not illegal. So long as the material obtained and shared in a legal way, there's nothing wrong with doxing appropriately. Some would argue journalists do it all the time. As Christine Belsek writes for the Daily Beast, sometimes a simple internet score can give you all you need to know and be legal to boot. In many cases, it's not even illegal. You can post it as long as there's nothing nefarious about it, says LAPD cybercrimes detective Andrew Klinick. There are public figures, and that kind of thing happens. It's not right, but I know it's of no crime. Doesn't take a master hacker to pull off such feats. Experts say that doxing has become almost commonplace when it comes to major celebrities. After all, finding a person's address or phone number is easy to do by searching the web or paying small fees online to online search providers. For an extra fee, plenty of search engines will also hand out phone numbers and addresses of next-door neighbors, as well as some criminal background information. It's when the information itself is used for illegal purposes, to defame, harass, or even annoy someone, or obtain illegally, hacking, etc., that doxing comes into the scope of the law. And as Whitney Gibson, a blogger with the Internet Defamation Removal Attorney blogs for Voris, notes, that doxing will likely stay legal even if it's sometimes used in an illegal way. So, even when it's being used illegally, doxing is still going to be classified as legal. And that seems to be a controversy in itself, because as it stated, if you get the information through legal means or pay the fees with a 50% chance of the accuracy being actually correct, that is perfectly fine. But if you hack for the information, then it's technically illegal. But because a lot of hackers, and I mean a lot of them, if not all of them, tend to use fake footprints when they do the hacking through Tor or other methods of hacking, then you can't trace it back to them as doing it as an illegal stance, because they can make it look like it was done legally. Let me go ahead and go into the next one. If we got two more left after this. Law forms, law discussion forms, which actually is pretty interesting since this is lawforms.org. Is doxing someone illegal? So we're going to see firsthand what the law says. I want to know if doxing personal identifiable information, usually through the source like Google and Facebook, etc., is illegal. A couple of people I know have been doxed online by someone who wants their website taken down, and they have no idea how to stop it. Is it punishable by law? And Emick had replied, "The law is strange sometimes, but I don't see how it could be illegal to use publicly access information published in good faith. Using stolen credentials to log into private pages on the other hand, would be illegal most places, i.e. accessing private Facebook pages without authorization, even if you got the password off some public hacking site. So, yeah. That's all we have right here on lawforms.org about if doxing is illegal or not. Clearly, there's some confusion if it's legal or not, but they seem to strongly stand that it is not illegal at all on this answer. And doxing. This is by the Daily Beast. Doxing, like hacking, but legal. Hillary, Beyonce, Ashton, they all got doxed this weekend. Christine Pelsky on cyber pranksters who post stars' private info for all to see and why that's often perfectly legal. Quick shout out to everybody who says everybody likes Beyonce. I don't like Beyonce. I really think she needs to just stop dressing the way that she does and take care of her kids and be a very much so modern modeled citizen for little kids, especially little girls, to look up to. I'm probably going to be the only feminist who says that I do not like Beyonce, which is going to be like a huge slap to all these other feminists' face. Michelle Obama's supposed social security number was posted. So was Beyonce's purported address and Ashton Kutcher's phone number, too. The list goes on. Joe Biden, Donald Trump, Hillary Rodham, Britney Spears, Mel Gibson, and Attorney General Eric Holder were all targeted in the information dump. In what must have been particularly galling note for law enforcement officials, the cyber attack also sussed out the allegated credit report of LAPD Chief Charles Beck. All those details and more were posted on the mysterious website The Secret Files, which as of Wednesday afternoon was back online after going dark for the day before. But this wasn't a hack attack, police and cybersecurity experts say. It's a classic case of doxing, the act of obtaining posting private information about a person by scouring the internet, and it's surprisingly easy to do. In many cases, it's not even illegal. So, right there, in many cases, it's not even illegal. So we have that gray grounds again. That it's either illegal or it's not illegal, and this is the gray area once more. I think this is the second website that I found that involves that gray ground area, or the third one. Yeah, it would be the third one. I think if Wikipedia didn't specify exactly if it was one of the three, but this is what makes it hard to understand about it being illegal or not. You can post it as long as there is nothing nefarious about it, says LAPD cybercrime detective Andrew Klinik. They are public figures and that kind of thing happens. It's not right, but I know of no crime. The expectation, says Klinik, occurs when information obtained through doxing is used to threaten someone, steal someone's identity, or infiltrate private emails. That was the case with 36-year-old Christopher Chaney, who 3 months ago was sentenced to a 10-year prison after hacking into email accounts of the actress Scarlett Johansson and Mila Kunis. So, this defines more of that gray area to the black and white areas, whereas the information obtained through doxing is used to threaten someone to steal someone's identity or infiltrate their private emails, much like what Christopher Chaney had done when he was sentenced to 10 years in prison, which would make this technically a crime, for hacking into the email accounts of Scarlett Johansson and Mila Kunis. So what he did by technicality through doxing is illegal because he was obtaining information through their accounts. It's still unclear who is accountable in the secret files. That LAPD officer Bruce Borhanian says the department is partnering with the FBI to find out more information and determine whether criminal charges apply. They are looking at the source, at the sourcing of it, Barihana says, and if it was obtained through illegal means, otherwise, it is information that was put out there before. So, if it was obtained illegally, such as somebody had accidentally made their phone number public, or made their address public, or their location public, then by that technicality, it's not illegal. But in some cases, much like how people try to get your boy Pat fired from Applebee's when he no longer works at Applebee's. He used to work there, but he no longer works there, and he was not fired for not working there. But the doxing happened to him where he had posted up in a Twitter with an image of himself in this garden, and the Applebee's hashtag came up, so people actually looked up his actual location, seriously thought he was working for that Applebee's, and started to call the restaurant to try and get your boy Pat fired. And they failed. Hard. In fact, from what I understand in Pat's video, he and his friend, who actually still works at that Applebee's, who I don't know, and I'm not going to be doxing him, they had a really good laugh about it, because his friend was answering the phone, who's the manager of that particular Applebee's, hearing this stuff, and he's like, yeah, he doesn't work here. Making the people who are calling the Applebee's location in general look like total tools to the doxing. So, if your boy Pat was working at that particular Applebee's at the time, it's likely that the manager would not have fired him anyways because of the fact that they are good friends. It is likely that the manager would have said, yeah, okay, moving on, bye, and just hung up and left everything as it is. And told Pat, by the way, people are calling about you, saying some political agenda stuff on the internet. Should we talk about it or just leave it as it is? And, you know, that would be a more private conversation for the two of them. Because Pat does not work at the Applebee's anymore, him and his friend both had a good hard laugh and chuckling about it and went about with their own lives. But the next time Pat had decided to do a live recording, it was not at the location that people have actually suspected him to do so. Much like when I do my YouTube videos, when you see me on my face cam talking to you guys personally this way, I'm either walking or I'm out in a public location, or there are the times when I'm actually sitting at my computer desk and I'm recording this and you don't know where I'm at because of how anonymous my identity is for myself. My social media sites like Facebook and such are separate, completely separate from my YouTube page, from my political stuff. Because I do know that people are going to be looking to dox me and looking to send me threats and harassments and such, would be looking to threaten my family. By the way, not a good thing. And so forth. So yeah, it is technically illegal, especially because the information is not obtained so easily that way. But at the same time, it's legal according to the LAPD officer who had specified, saying, yeah, it's not a crime, but it's not legal either. This isn't the first time that LAPD has been doxxed. In 2011, a group affiliated with Online Hackers Anonymous claimed responsibility for posting personal information about more than 40 officers, including their home addresses, campaign contributions, property records, and names of family members, after they claimed LAPD oppressed them by shutting down the Occupy LA movement. Last I checked, I might be wrong about this, but last I checked, Anonymous does not really get involved in anything political, so I could be wrong about that. Somebody could actually correct me on that, please do so. But it doesn't take a master hacker to pull off such feat. Experts says that doxing has become almost commonplace when it comes to major celebrities. After all, finding a person's address or phone number is easy to do by searching on the web or paying small fees to online search providers. For an extra fee, plenty of search engines will also hand out phone numbers and addresses of next-door neighbors, as well as some criminal background information. And then they go on to talk more about the cyber crimes, the more doxing, secret files, website, and Clinic himself says he became a victim of cyber intrusion after a person he was investigating posted some of his private information on the web. Still, he says that was a while plenty of people have incurred the wrath of these pesky cyber seekers. It is technically not a reportable crime. If it's just posting personal information, we don't take a report because it's not illegal. Sorry, Ashton. So, yeah. LAPD officer is saying that doxing is not illegal. However, like I said, if you feel like you are being threatened because of the dox information, contact the police. Because then that does become a life-threatening situation for you and your family and would be taken far more serious than I'm guessing originally. So, what did I learn about doxing exactly? Well, I really didn't learn anything in regards on if it's legal or illegal. That's not something that I could really say is a thing or is not a thing. And I don't know where exactly to go from here when it comes to the future of doxing itself. I do hope that Bearing, Sugar Tits, and their family do get the proper recovery and help on finding out who it was that purposely leaked their information on Encyclopedia Dramatica to humiliate them, make sure harassers and trolls would get their information, send threats to them, and would actually face a similar justice in their own way. Because by technicality, doxing is not hacking. Doxing is not illegal, according to several sites. Doxing is illegal, according to a small minority group of sites, but is still being told doxing is not illegal. And then there is the gray grounds themselves about doxing being illegal or legal. So whoever doxed Bearing, be warned, you may end up getting doxed yourself, and you might find yourself in the exact position that Bearing is sitting in right now. And there would be nothing you can do about it, much like there is nothing that Bearing can do about it himself, according to the LA police officer. I don't know about the worldwide rules about doxing, so if it is illegal in Australia, then don't do it. If it is legal, like